Straight Outta Compton's kitchen. My name is Valerie Vaults, better known to you as Chef Vivio. And as my Aunt Sadie would say, my dad's sister, as she would say, how y'all doing? And as my Auntie Shug would say, my mom's sister, y'all all right? Yes, so we just want to make sure I'm praying that you're having peace in the midst of this pandemic, faith in the midst of floods and fires, encouragement in the midst of earthquakes, inspiration in the midst of injustice, strength in the midst of the storms of life, and I hope you're not allowing anybody to jack you for your joy. Today we're going to make black bean burgers. As you know, I am pescatarian, which means I have given up meat, but I still eat seafood. Okay, and I still love a good burger. So I make my burgers with black beans now. And in this recipe, I'm going to use the seasoned recipe of the Bush's version of black beans. But you can get it with or without salt. You decide. Okay. All right, so from there, we're gonna go with the bell pepper. We're gonna take, a half of a bell pepper, which is about 3/4 cup, chopped finely. A half of an onion, chopped finely. We're gonna use the 2 cage-free eggs, which means the chicken was running around outside having a good time eating good food, not just, you know, put in some factory and just not free at all, just bound. So we're not using those eggs. We're using the cage-free eggs. We're using a tablespoon of minced garlic, or you can use 3 cloves of garlic chopped fine. But I'm gonna use 1 tablespoon. I'm also going to use 1.5 teaspoons of this cumin, ground cumin. I'm gonna use 1 teaspoon of chili powder. I'm going to use 1/4 teaspoon of the smoked paprika. I am going to use 1 tablespoon of this, what's this here sauce, as my friend Scott would say. Scott, if you're listening, I'm gonna use 1 tablespoon of this, what's this here sauce? And I'm gonna use 1/2 cup of breadcrumbs. All right, now, I think I'm gonna make 3 batches of my my burgers. I think all of this will make up to maybe 12 patties. So I think I'm gonna divide it into 3, and I'm gonna add the ketchup because I wanna see what that tastes like. That's 2 tablespoons of ketchup, 2 tablespoons of mayo, and I'm gonna try the vegan mayo, see what that tastes like. Or you can try 2 tablespoons of your barbecue sauce. Add a little pinch of salt and pepper if you feel you might need that, just a pinch. And after everything is done, we're gonna go over the instructions. I'm going to prepare it right here in the kitchen and put it, after everything is done, I'm gonna put it on my King's Hawaiian hamburger bun. And I may add, you know, some spinach instead of lettuce. I'm not really a tomato person, but yeah, And I'm definitely gonna add some cheese. Now this is the reason I am not a vegan, because of this cheese that I just love. So I'm gonna put that on my black bean burger. And who knows, I may put a little bit of bacon. I'm gonna show you how I make vegetarian bacon. Okay guys, I wanted to show you the black beans. I poured the water off the black beans first. Then I spreaded them out on a cookie sheet or baking sheet, and I lined it with foil. Put this in an oven, 350 degrees, for about 15 minutes. And while I was baking my beans, I sauteed my bell pepper, my chopped onion, and a tablespoon of the garlic. When I come back, I'm gonna mix it all together and start with the binding. Okay, so I wanted to say to you, happy Sunday, first and foremost. I went to the store this morning to pick up some of the items for my burger. And I noticed that a lot of cars were in some of the church parking lots. I said, y'all go ahead. Oh, but I said, your girl is only going to the store, the post office, and the gas station. I will go and see my parents, and my son and my grandson, they usually come here and over to my parents' house. So that's the most socializing that I'm doing, okay? And I said, you know, when it comes to the church, we are the church. When Jesus comes back for us, he's coming back for the people, not for the buildings. And the other thing that has resonated with my soul is it's not about a location, it's about a lifestyle. And it's not about a religion, it's about a relationship. So that's how I feel, that's how I roll. I went to the filling station today with my mentor, Jewel Diamond Taylor, if you're listening, and the Women on the Grow, if you're listening. Yeah, we had a really good day today. Just going over, you know, just confronting stuff, issues, you know, and getting it right. We're growing. Women on the Grow. They call us Women on the Grow for a reason. We are still growing up. And what else did I want to say? It's something else I wanted to say. Well, I guess I'll just have to come back and tell it to you at that time when I'm putting all the mixture together. Like I said, I'm going to do three separate mixtures. I'm going to have one with ketchup. I'm going to have another one with the barbecue sauce. And I'm going to have another one with mayonnaise. And I'm going to try the veganaise, which is vegan mayonnaise. All right, I'm going to try that. And also, I told you guys, I'm going to come back with a surprise vegan bacon. Okay, so what we have here now are the baked beans. And they look really good. But what I'm going to do is put them in my Ninja. Pat Hobbs, if you're listening, my cousin Pat Hobbs, Addie Pay, if you're listening, I'm still using my Ninja girl. So I'm gonna put some of the beans, most of the beans in here. We wanna leave some where they're whole. And we don't want it to be mushy, you know? But there's gonna be some things that's gonna take care of the binding of this mixture for us. So like I sauteed the onions, the garlic, the bell pepper. In order for it not to be too mushy, I had to blot it with a paper towel so that most of that oil would come off of there. I'm still gonna add, I think, a little bit of onion and bell pepper that's raw. So it'll be a little crunchy in there. I think I'm gonna like that. So, okay. I'm gonna add the beans, and I'll let you see what that looks like. And I'll let you see the mixture as to how it's looking as well. I thought of what I wanted to say. I was thinking about all this stuff that I have behind me. It's most of the ingredients for the black bean patties. But I was just thinking about how nosy I am when I'm in a Zoom room with my coworkers. You know, I'll be looking in the background. Curtis, if you're listening, I'll be looking at your kitchen, and your backyard is absolutely beautiful. And, you know, I think one time, George, if you're listening, I doubt it, but I think one time he had somebody, oh no, it wasn't George, it was Glenn. One time he had somebody walking around in the background. I was like, is that his wife? I mean, I was just all up in it. So I know y'all all up in my Kool-Aid, yes. So these are the ingredients that I'm gonna be using. All right, and if you're interested in my artwork, it's all by Monica Stewart. All of that is by her. I buy her work because my theme is the woman in the red dress. Everything that you see, some type of an accessory, is usually a woman in a red dress. So, yeah. All right, so I'll be back. Talk to you soon. Welcome back to Straight Outta Compton's Kitchen. Okay, so here are the results, y'all. I don't know if you noticed, I had this little sign up that says truth. So I think I'm gonna put this sign out when I am trying something for the very first time. And then I'll put this one out that says believe. This is the one that you guys are used to seeing. And when I put this one out, believe you me, it tastes good, y'all. I know what I'm doing. I've been doing it for a while. Believe that. But today, with these black bean burgers, we're going to do truth or dare. I'm going to tell you the truth. I did not like the way they came out. Okay, in terms of how... they were too moist. I kept adding flour. I added almond flour. I added breadcrumbs, more breadcrumbs to try to make it bind, but it was really, really wet. So with the ingredients that I gave you all, it's going to be wet. So you may have to add more flour. And like I said, I used almond flour and I used more breadcrumbs. The other thing is I did two tests. I put one patty in the oven so I could bake it. I did not like the texture. Just don't look good. I put the other one on top of the stove and, you know, I pan fried it. So that one looks a little bit better. And this is pretty much it. That's how that looks. So here we go. This is my taste test. I put spinach, I put raw onions, and I also put the applewood smoked cheddar. And I'm using the vegan mayonnaise on my buns. That was the other thing. I added barbecue sauce to my mixture. I didn't add, you know, remember I said I was gonna do one with mayo, one with ketchup, one, too much work, y'all. So I just did it with the barbecue sauce. And I put the vegan mayo on my buns. All right, so here we go. I'm gonna take a taste test. All right. I'm gonna tell you what it would taste good in. Make yourself a black bean burrito and add everything that you would want in a burrito and use this mixture. For a burger, I'm gonna stick to my spicy black bean Morningstar frozen patties. I'm gonna stick to that. And you know what else this one needs is some relish. I think the other thing that's kind of slowing it down is the real mayo. I'll be right back. Oops. Okay, y'all, what I decided to do was go and get me some real mayo. Okay. I don't know about this vegan mayo. And I love me some sweet relish. This is like my pickles, substitute pickles. So I'm putting that on there. So let's take another bite and see. That's number one. You need some pickles. That's number two. If you're gonna make you a bean burger. Otherwise, honey, throw it in a tortilla shell and keep it to pushing. Add your onions. What else would you add to a burrito? You wanna put some lettuce in there. Chopped tomato, doctor it up the way you would want to doctor it up. Go ahead, the mixture still needs to be cooked because remember you added raw eggs and the eggs were in there to help with the binding. So listen, if you're not gonna make a burger and you choose to make a burrito, which is what I strongly suggest for this mixture, don't add any eggs. Put it in the oven, let it get hot, wrap that bad boy up in a tortilla shell, and you got you a black bean burrito. But in the meantime, I'm gonna go ahead on and eat this with some real mayo, some pickle relish, onions. I put some spinach in there, and my applewood cheddar cheese.